Well, I'm Bill Crowder. I'm Ray Scheibel. And I went to Vietnam in 1968 in the summer. And I came out of Vietnam in June of 70. Almost 2 years.
I arrived in Vietnam in October 1970 and departed in October 1971. I was stationed in Da Nang in I Corps in the north, and I commanded the 264th Transportation Company for the entire year. Yeah, I was a captain at the time. I was a ROTC graduate out of Penn State University, and we got my commission through the ROTC program there, and wound up spending 20 years in the military and retired in 1987.
And I was commissioned at the University of Alabama in 1966 and went to Vietnam as a first lieutenant and commanded 97th Heavy Boat Company and then stayed there longer to be in the battalion S3 and came out as a captain.
Well, for me personally, it was another assignment. I did not have any problems wherever the Army sent me. My first assignment was in Germany. I was up on the east-west German border in the armored cab, 2nd and 14th armored cab in Bad Kissingen. We were patrolling the border there between east and west Germany. And then it came time for me to leave Germany, and I got orders to go to Vietnam. So I was just following orders to go there. When I came back, it was a little upsetting because the reception wasn't anywhere near what the troops got out of Desert Shield, Desert Storm, or in subsequent wars. If I remember right, I arrived back by a chartered flight. I was in uniform. I arrived at in Ford Air Force Base up in the state of Washington, Seattle, and they told us to change out of our uniforms and put civilian clothes on to take the flight from Seattle over to Philadelphia. I came back to
it. A little different. My first assignment was in Fort Knox, Kentucky. And as a second lieutenant, I got to get all the young men who were voting with their feet not to go to Vietnam, the youngsters who came back and had either gone AWOL or deserted. I was in the unit that brought them back to active duty. And after about 10 months of that, I said, I can't do this anymore unless I've been where they've been. So I went to Vietnam and basically planned to stay 1 year and get out of the Army. And met some really great people there that made me think the Army is where I needed to be, and ended up commanding there and then staying in the Army. That was in the draft part of the Army, and this was all the youngsters who came back. And the Army had a real problem because they would come back and they would process them through reception centers and tell them to go home, and they'd get their orders later. They couldn't get them their orders, and then the local sheriffs would go out and police them up. And so it was a tough time for everybody. There were others who just walked.
All right.
But it was tough for all of us. When I came back from Vietnam, I was stationed in Oakland, California, in the middle of UC Berkeley. And to say that wasn't a warm reception is a slight understatement compared to what we were getting. But it changed over time. People now are more understanding, I think, of what was going on for all of us back then than they were when we came back in the 70s.
Bill and I didn't know each other until about 1990.
Are you good buddies now?
Yes. We wound up working together in the Army staff, and also later on when we both retired, we became, I call them, Parkway Patriots, supporting the Department of Defense from a contractor standpoint for the logistics management. And we've been supporting the Army since the early 1990s as Parkway Patriots.